We did keep Calvin around for 5 generations, to be exact. Having spent all my money in support of the South, I sold my house to my pal, J.J. Granberry, for $22,000. J.J. wanted to change the name from Rattle and Snap to Granberry Oaks. However, his wife preferred Oakwood Hall. 14 years passed by, and on December 27, 1881, J.J. wrote a deed in contemplation of death, naming his wife and his son James as benefactors. 12 cold, snowy days later, J.J. Granberry was laid to rest in St. John's Cemetery, just up the road from the farm. A black-edged letter announcing his death was delivered to the prominent citizens of Maury County. His wife and his sons continued to run the farm for 38 more years. The scars from the war were slowly healing, and I want you to listen close to what old J.J. has to say.